is the president, Muhammadu Buhari, and his wife, Her Excellency Ajia Aisha Buhari. Your Excellency, the Vice President, Professor Emi Osibari. My wife, Oluremi Tinubu. Thank you. I can only call you Mr. Democrat. You have bestowed the nation's highest honor on my vice president-elect, Shetima Ami. Our deep thanks also for the transition document, which clearly enumerated the effort of the past 8 years. The document summarizes the main work of your administration. They consult an impressive and noteworthy scorecard. You have made history, and no one can deny your contribution to our national development. Your devotion to progressive and democratic governance is as eligible. I stand here today, renewed in hope and dedication to our national greatness. I also feel full of pride that this moment is our moment, and I know what it represents. This testless occasion is proof that Nigeria is vibrant and true democracy. It confirms that our democratic path is right and is right, and nothing will deter us from sticking to it. We shall not be always smooth, yes. Democracy is rough and tumble, hills and valleys. Yet we are imbued with faith in our purpose and belief in our collective ability to overcome the challenges that confront us. President Buhari, you have shown courage and taken tough decisions others avoided. On such decision is to recognize the injustice of annulment of 1993 election, to designate June 12th as a Democracy Day, and to bestow the nation's highest honor on late MKO Abiola. As much as anyone could, you reach back into history to set the record straight and heal the festering wound. Thank you. The justice you did in this matter lent special meanings to today. The people have put their trust in us. You have done your part, Mr. President. Now, a great duty will descend on me. I understand the meaning of the honor given to me today and the magnitude of the task that awaits. Whether you go to Daura or Niger or anywhere, you expect knocks on your doors. We are determined, as enumerated, on security, economy, agriculture, jobs, education, health and power, and in all sectors, we must make headway, as you've charted the course. The people deserve no less. Is that so? I shall not disappoint you. That